For this lesson, you need to open the sample file First Quarter Sales and Profit 12 from your Sample Files folder. We aren't going to explore every option for preparing and printing a worksheet in this lesson. Printing is such a huge subject that we devote a whole session to it in Session 7, Printing Your Work. This lesson only aims to teach you the bare minimum skills you need to put your work onto paper. In order to print a worksheet, we need to go into Backstage View. To do that, click File on the ribbon and then click Print on the left-hand menu bar. Notice that Backstage View shows a preview of how the worksheet will look when it's printed. You learned all about this in Lesson 114, but for a recap, let's first zoom the preview. To zoom the preview, I'll click the Zoom to Page button on the bottom right of the screen, and when I click, the page is zoomed so that I can see the contents more clearly. I'll now click the button once more so that I can see the whole page in the preview pane. You can also see two navigation buttons towards the left of the preview. I can use these navigation buttons to iterate through each of the pages in a multiple page printout. You'll remember that you use this feature in Lesson 114. Let's now look at the print options on the center panel of the dialog. First of all, you can see Copies 1. This means that you'll only print one copy of the worksheet, but you may want to click several copies, for example, for a handout at a meeting, and you can use the spin buttons to change the number of copies that will be printed. Next, we have the selection of the printer. I'll click the drop-down arrow to see all of the printers that are attached to this computer. And you can see that I have two real printers, a Hewlett-Packard LaserJet 2420 and an HP DeskJet 1220. I'll stay with my default selection of my LaserJet 2420. Underneath the printer, you can see a Printer Properties hyperlink. Now, what will happen when you click this hyperlink will be different on your computer to mine, because the printer properties are set by the printer manufacturer, and every printer has different capabilities and different properties. I'll click Printer Properties for my LaserJet 2420, and you can see two simple dialogues and also an advanced button showing more of the complex options for this printer. I'll click Cancel to cancel that dialog and cancel again. And let's look at the printer properties for my other printer, my DeskJet 1220C. In this case, you can see that there are more involved properties because this printer has a few extra features. I'll click Cancel and cancel, and I'll go back to my Hewlett-Packard 2420 printer. Now let's look at the print settings. The first one, Print Active Sheets, means to print any sheets you currently have selected. Selecting multiple sheets was covered in Lesson 1.9. Normally, you'll only have one sheet selected. Let's just go back to the worksheet and see this now by clicking the Back button at the top left of the screen. And you can see that only Sheet 1 is currently selected. But in Lesson 1.9, you learned how to select multiple worksheets. I'll hold down the Control key and click Sheet 2, and you can see that I now have both Sheet 1 and Sheet 2 selected, and if I left things like this, I'd print the contents of both sheets, though in this case, Sheet 2 is actually empty. I'll hold down Control again now and click Sheet 2 to return things to normal with only Sheet 1 selected. And now I'll click the File button and the Print button on the left-hand menu bar to return to Backstage View. As well as Print Active Sheets, there's an option to print the entire workbook. If you wanted to print out the contents of every worksheet in the workbook, you could select this option, and that would save you having to select all of the sheets. And the final option is quite interesting, Print Selection. Let's look at that option now. I'll click the Back button to return to the worksheet and select cells A3 to F9. I'll now click the File tab again and then click Print to return to Backstage View. And instead of Print Active Sheets, I'll select Print Selection. And look at the preview on the right. You can see that I'll now only print the currently selected cells. But I'll change that setting back to Print Active Sheets, which is the one you'll use most of the time. Now consider a very long worksheet that's going to print on multiple sheets of paper. The default setting is to print all pages in the worksheet. But you could print, for example, page 2 to page 4 by using the spin buttons on the pages boxes. If you wanted to print from page 2 to the end of the worksheet, you could leave the second setting blank and Excel would know what you wanted to do. But I'll leave both of these boxes blank now to print the entire worksheet. Let's now look at the next setting, Print One-Sided. Now you may or may not see this on your own copy of Excel, because the selected printer might not be able to print on both sides of the paper. But my printer is a duplex printer. In other words, it does have the ability to print on both sides of the sheet of paper. So I could use this setting to print on one side or both sides. The first option, Flip Pages on Long Edge, would assume that these pages were going to be bound into a typical book format, with the binding on the left-hand side. That's the long edge. And the second option would assume that I was going to bind the book in a notebook format, where the binding would appear along the top of the book, in other words, on the short edge. But let's stay with Print One-Sided, because that's what you'll do most of the time. Now let's consider Collated. Imagine you have a workbook with 5 pages, and you're going to print out several copies, let's say 10 copies for a meeting. If you select the Collated option, which is the default, you'll get page 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 printed first, then another copy, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then another copy, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that will make it very easy to staple the 5 sheets of paper together to produce the 10 handout sets. But sometimes you'll want them to print differently. You'll want all of the page 1s to print, that would be 10 copies of page 1, then 10 copies of page 2, then 10 copies of page 3. If that was your requirement, you'd select Uncollated. But we'll leave this setting at Collated, and I'll put that number of copies setting back to 1. And now let's look at orientation. At the moment, we have portrait orientation, but if I click the drop-down, you can see there's an option of both portrait and landscape. Landscape means that we print across the page instead of down the page. It's easier to show you what I mean by that. I'll select landscape orientation and watch the preview on the right of the screen. You can see that the paper is flipped on its side, and that gives me a lot more room on the right-hand side of the printout. So you'd choose landscape orientation if you had a wide printout that wasn't fitting on one sheet of paper. Let's now go back to portrait orientation. Next, we need to select the size of the paper we're going to use. Let me click the drop-down to see all of the available sizes. Now, you may not see all of these sizes on your computer. That's because you'll only see paper sizes that your printers support. For most of the world, you'll use the A4 size as a normal paper size. But in the USA and Canada, you'll usually use the letter size paper, because letter size paper is only generally used in those countries. I'll stay with A4. Next, we need to talk about the margins. The margins are the blank areas on the paper, on the left, the right, the top, and the bottom. At the moment, you can see we have normal margins. Let's now click on the drop-down arrow to see the settings for normal margins. You can see that normal margins mean 1.91 centimetres at the top and bottom and 1.78 centimetres on the left and right. You can also see there's a setting for header and footer. you're going to learn all about headers and footers in Session 7. Sometimes you'll need to punch holes on your sheets of paper to place them in a binder, and the holes might punch through the text in the printout. In this case, you'll want to go for wide margins. Watch the preview carefully as I click Wide Margins. I'll click Now, and you can see that there's now more space to punch those holes. Let's look at the final setting now, which is Narrow. Often you'll find a printout that won't quite fit on the sheet of paper, and by reducing the margins to their narrowest possible values, you might just squeeze the printout on. Let's click Narrow now and watch the margins shrink. I'll click Narrow, and the margins reduce to the narrowest possible settings. I'll now return to normal margins to put things back to the normal way that you'll print out. The final option is scaling. Sometimes you'll have a worksheet that won't fit on a sheet of paper. It's too big. And of course, the only way to fit it on the sheet of paper will be to shrink the size of all of the text so that it fits. If I click the drop-down arrow next to No Scaling, you'll see there's an option to fit all of the worksheet onto one page. For a very large worksheet, of course, this may make the type too small to read. You can see there's also an option for Fit All Columns on One Page, and another for Fit All Rows on One Page. Having set up my printout, all I'd have to do would be to click the Print button, and the worksheet would print on my selected printer. But to save paper, I won't print now. I'll click the Back button now at the top left of the screen to return to the worksheet. And you've now completed Lesson 223, Print Out a Worksheet.